Welcome to the first episode of Bampas Woodshop. My name is Jim Connolly, and I retired from the Boston Fire Department about 5 years ago, at which point I started cleaning up all those home projects that got put off year after year. And finally, when they were done, I could get out to my wood shop and make some fun things. Today, I'd like to share with you one project that I've made dozens of. This is a magnetic bottle opener, which I make using various types of woods, both domestic and exotic. So who's ready to make a magnetic bottle opener with me? Let's get out to the shop and get started. Welcome back. I've already taken the time to go through my lumber stock, and I've pulled out the various pieces of lumber, the various pieces of woods that I'm going to use for this project, and I've already arranged them, and I think in an eye-appealing manner. These are some of the blanks. And some of the wood I have is Padauk. I believe this is Bocate. We have cherry, some maple, walnut. This is rosewood. It has a nice little pink color to it. More maple, walnut, another piece of rosewood. Padauk, another piece of purple heart. This is called tiger wood, not to be confused with the golfer. And over here, we got another piece of purple heart and Padauk with maple in between. More tiger wood, cocobolo. I believe this yellowish piece of wood is called Camoro. And that's about it. So now the next step is to glue them all up. And in order to glue them up, I have to run all these boards through the joiner planer so we get a nice smooth surface, so when the boards get together, there's no voids. So let's head out to the shop now. I'll take you to the joiner planer, and we'll plane these down and get them ready for glue up. All right, the next step in the process is to get the gluing surfaces nice and smooth to ensure a nice tight fit with no voids. And the best tool to accomplish that is this tool right here, the joiner planer. So before we start up the machinery, make sure you put your safety glasses on. Let's get going. Tight the fit is without any gaps in between. That's going to make for a good strong glue hold. Now, in order to glue this up, we got to go back to the kitchen table. All right, now that the boards have all been planed and they're smooth enough, it's time to do the glue up and the clamping. Hey, that's good for now. I can get a much cleaner job, but I'll do that off camera. And now, we just wait until it dries, take it all apart, put it through the planer, the thickness planer, and when that's all set, we'll come back and pick up where we left off. Okay, the glue has had overnight to set, and the next step is to take the clamps off and scrape off the excess glue and get ready to go through the thickness planer. So, let's get it done. Thickness. Next step now is to trim up the edges, cut it down to size. I should be able to get two out of this. Oh, and then we'll move on from there. All right, now that I got them all planed down to thickness, uniform thickness, nice and smooth, the next step is to clean up the edges and cut them down to size. And I should be able to get two out of this board. Let's get rolling. Not every board is cut and dry straight like this. Sometimes I take them and I use my Forstner bits to drill holes partly way, different size holes. I'll use four different sizes today. And later on I will come back with different colored epoxies and fill them in. I call it the bubble look. they don't look too good right now. But once I get the colored epoxy going and I fill them in and sand it down, it's gonna look pretty decent, I hope. Stay tuned. All right, now that we have the holes filled, the next step is to mix the epoxy. And this is a two-part system. In this system, one pump each gives you a measured amount, which is just right. Once I mix that up, I will add the various colors. This one's yellow, this one's gold, this is blue, this is pink. And to save time and a little bit of money, because this stuff is expensive, I'll start with the lightest color first and pour some, then I'll add the other colors to it and see what we get. And we might have to do that twice. So, all right, here we go, one pump each. Okay, I got the first color done, yellow. That's what it looks like. I haven't shown you already. It's time to fill some of these holes. Now that that's done, my next step is to add another color. I think I will add blue and see what we get. Before I go any further, I got to get the bubbles. Air bubbles are forming in this. The only way, the best way to get rid of it is with heat. And you can watch the bubbles just pretty much just pop. On to the next color. I'm not sure if this will work, but I'm going to put pink in and see what happens to the blue. I feel we'll get a nice deep purple out of this. All right, this should be our last pour. We only got three holes to fill. And this turned out to be a very deep purple. Let this set overnight, let it harden up, and I'll take it to the sander, sand it down nice and smooth, and all these little glitches and spills will disappear, and then we'll be ready to start adding the hardware and the final steps of this project. Okay, now the next step is to sand these down smooth and get them ready for the router, and I'll be using 120 grit, then move up to 180. And finally 220. And once I'm done cycling it all through, then I'll take it to the router and we'll put a decorative edge on it. All right. I've sanded through 120, 180, and 220 grit. The next step is to put a nice edge along these four sides, and in order to do that, I use this tool called the router table. Down, and I got one left to do. I just want to show you the difference before and after with a little bit of oil, how it makes the grain pop right out. Oh, Later on, once this stuff somewhat dries, I'll move on to the next step. Stay tuned. As you can see, I got about 24 of these things I'm working, and most of them are already got their finish on it, and I'll just have to put the hardware. But this one, I am gonna give it a bar top finish using a two-part epoxy. This hanger on the back, bottle opener itself on the front, we'll add this magnet to the bottom, and then decide whether we're going to put an air cap on one of these sports boat rooms or the magnet. Alright, now let's get started. Whether we're going to put a bottle cap or one of these on. I think bobcat will do just fine. And that's the end of it. Now, ideally, when you open up your beer bottle, the bottle cap will fall. Most of the time, and stick to the main. Well, there you have it. One magnetic bottle opener made out of exotic woods. This one is with different various color epoxies. And as you can see, they have a few more to finish off. Some of which I will add other trinkets such as this, or maybe a Patriots logo, or whatever other logos I may find. Some people bring me their logos and I incorporate it. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this project. Stay tuned. I'm sure we'll have a few more projects and more shows to share with you. Have a good day.